Hey everyone, this is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team, and today we're launching three new free downloadable example puppets, Bunnie, Frenchie, and Foxie. These adorable little creatures were created by our friend Emily Watts, who we've featured several times on this channel before. And they have a lot of awesome features, from smooth head turns to walking with foreground and background parallax, and smart use of shared puppets to help with file organization. As always, you're allowed to use these however you want in your own projects, and the download link is in the video description below. I asked Emily to talk through her process and give some tips, so here you go.
Hi, character animator friends. My name is Emily Watts, and I created a few puppets for everyone to play with. When I use character animator, I'm typically using it for scripted narrative pieces, so I need fully loaded puppets that can do all the basics. They need to be able to walk and talk and stop and face any direction and gesture with their hands, and I like to make their head turns as smooth as possible. So those are all pretty basic behaviors, but when you load them all into a single puppet, the file size can get really big and a little unwieldy. So the most important thing that I've learned in creating these kind of fully loaded puppets is to use shared body parts. Let's go into rig mode and I'll show you what I'm talking about. You'll see that Frenchie has a right quarter and a left quarter view so that he can walk to the left and the right, and then this non-walk group that has four different directions that he can stop and stand in. Now that means that each of these six views is going to have its own head and body group. And if you were to just copy all of your head artwork into all of these groups, that's where your file size is going to start getting a little out of control. But luckily you don't have to. This icon here indicates that this group is being shared. So this is a shared puppet part. And if we look at the original Frenchie Photoshop file, you'll see that the head group actually is only in one of these views. So when I imported my artwork from Photoshop, all I have to do is right click on my head group, and then I click Make Head Shareable. And that creates a separate head puppet over here that I can easily just drag into the remaining views. So they all have a head associated with them, but it's all referencing one set of original artwork. So that keeps your file nice and light, but gives you a pretty flexible puppet that can move and stop and face all these different directions. For me, this is particularly important because my head artwork gets pretty heavy. I like to have these additional cycle layers within the main profile views so that I can have these nice smooth head turns. Now creating all the artwork for a puppet like this can be a little bit daunting. I used a 3D modeling program to create these puppets, and then I was able to just work on a single model and save down images from every different head angle that I needed and body angle to create all of this artwork. So there you have it. Foxie, Frenchie, and Bunnie are here for you to use and to reference as you're making your own walking, talking, fully loaded puppets. I hope you'll take them on some fun adventures.
Very cool stuff. Thank you, Emily. So feel free to check these characters out and make your own animated adventures with them, or study their structure and implement some of Emily's techniques for your own creations. Please share anything you make on social media with hashtag characteranimator so we can see what you're up to. And if you don't understand something about these puppets or need further assistance making your own, the best place for help is the official Adobe Character Animator forums. That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching and have fun.